السلام عليكم. Let's start the second part of this long topic, role of ultrasound in gynecological emergencies from infants to post-menopause. We are still in the neonatal and infancy period, and we will talk now about normal ovaries. It passes into three stages. The first one in neonatal period. Due to passage of maternal hormones, it will become larger size, large follicles about 1 centimeter, easily detected by any probe. After the first few weeks, it will go into silent phase, smaller follicles, smaller size of the ovary, difficult to be detected. It needs a window like full bladder to see it. During puberty, it may simulate the appearance of adult ovary, multiple follicles with the dominant one, and ovulation start to appear. Okay, during childhood, it's difficult to be detected using the convex probe. So it's much easier if we use a higher frequency probe, higher resolution probe, as transvaginal probe through abdominal wall, or better, linear probe through abdominal lobe. But if we use linear probe, the reverse is here. Empty urinary bladder, especially in cases of suspected ovarian lesions, ovarian torsion, ovarian mass, I need to see just follicles. So get the bladder empty, the ovary will be closer to the anterior abdominal wall, so easily to be characterized by this higher resolution probe. Inshallah, I will talk in details in about this topic in the next lecture. Okay, starting our cases. The first one, newborn female child with suspected abdominal mass by the clinician, by her mother, or another scenario. Antenatal suspected pelvic abdominal mass coming for postnatal follow-up. This is, by the way, the commonest scenario. We see here a large pelvic abdominal cystic lesion reaching down to the uterus or the urinary bladder, reaching up to the gallbladder and liver or the kidney. The commonest cystic mass in fetus, a female fetus, is ovarian cyst. In a female neonate, also ovarian cyst, especially if we see this finding. This is classic daughter cyst. Daughter cyst is pathognomonic to ovarian nature, ovarian origin. So this is a simple ovarian cyst. After follow-up 3 weeks, start to reduce in size, so the ovarian parenchyma start to appear containing multiple follicles on each side. It needs follow-up until third or fourth months. Okay. Another case, large pelvic abdominal cystic lesion, either found by the clinician or by the mother, or the other common scenario, antenatal finding. Okay, we found here this large cyst containing multiple daughter cysts. After 4 weeks follow-up, reduced in size and start to disappear. This is simple ovarian cyst. Another case, female newborn with large swelling detected by clinician or detected antenatally by gynecologist or radiologist. Postnatal follow-up showed large pelvic abdominal complex cystic lesion, fluid debris level with daughter cyst. Daughter cyst suggests its ovarian nature. Fluid level, fluid debris level suggests complicated. If the ovary of the ovarian cyst become complicated, it carries high risk of torsion. And by the way, torsion is more common in intrauterine life than in neonatal life. Okay. In all cases, we use the linear probe for higher resolution. Okay, and this is virtual convex or wide screen. So this was a neonatal hemorrhagic cyst or complicated cyst. Daughter cyst means ovarian, fluid means complicated or hemorrhagic, and this is a MRI complementary study confirms the diagnosis. The last case, complex cystic lesion starting downwards from the uterus, superior aspect of uterus and the urinary bladder. This is LS, and this is TS and the upper abdomen. This complex cystic lesion reach up to the liver and compressing the bowel and stomach posteriorly against the midline, containing no vascularity, no perceptible vascularity, and its appearance like fishnet appearance, reticular appearance, lace-like appearance, as the adult hemorrhagic ovarian cyst. So this is also a ovarian hemorrhagic cyst. Ovarian hemorrhagic cyst carries high risk of torsion. It was found on surgery. It was necrotic cyst due to torsion. So, by incidence, the most common abdominal mass in a female fetus, in a female neonate, is ovarian cyst. And most of these cases are benign, simple cyst. It will resolve within few weeks to few months after life. Okay, like this cyst discovered antenatally, postnatal follow-up, simple ovarian cyst. It will resolve with time. The other cases, if show complications, complicated cyst like fluid debris level, reticulations, internal septi, absent vascularity, or maybe too much daughter cyst. All these findings suggest the possibility of torsion starting in utero and maybe continue in postnatal life. If you suspecting torsion, do MRI. This is another case from my practice, antenatally sent by a clinician suspecting mass. If suspecting fetal mass, I have to rule out renal and adrenal masses. So the mass not attached to any of the kidneys, so it's not nephroblastoma. It's below the level of the kidneys, so it's not neuroblastoma. On one side of the urinary bladder, most likely ovarian, and no vascularity with classic reticular pattern, fishnet appearance, lace-like appearance, hemorrhagic, and confirmed by MRI, high T1, high T2. In postnatal follow-up, it become more complex, starting down from superior aspect of uterus and urinary bladder up to liver and gallbladder, compressing the bowel and stomach posteriorly. It was diagnosed as hemorrhagic ovarian cyst. The possibility of torsion is high in such cases. Main differential diagnosis is teratoma, like this case. Abdominal, pelvi-abdominal cystic lesion, complex, exactly like hemorrhagic cyst. Fluid appearance, but on surgery it was dermoid. So remember, the most common abdominal or pelvi-abdominal mass in a female fetus or a female neonate is ovarian. Most of these cases will be benign. It needs just sonographic follow-up. If showed complications like septations, like fluid level, it needs a confirmation by MRI to rule out the possibility of torsion or close sonographic follow-up. Thank you and assalamu alaikum.